Hey folks, Matt from RightOfTheImage.com. Hot on the heels of Sony's recent RX100 Mark VI, the successor to the very successful RX100 Mark V, Mark IV, Mark III, and so on. It's an amazing little pocket camera that's basically almost a DSLR replacement. Amazing performing 1-inch sensor, very good fast lens, and 4K video, and a host of other things that'll all fit in your pocket. Very popular, and I've reviewed it here. I really like the RX100s. Also a big fan of its competitor, the LX10 from Panasonic. But what I want to talk about here is we had the RX100 Mark VI come out, and it had a bit of a difference in lenses. Instead of the 24-70 equivalent with the 1.8-28 lens, which is my favorite because it's a very fast lens and a great usable focal length, we had a 24-200 equivalent. It is a slower lens. It was a 2.8-4.5. I'm just double checking here. Yeah, 2.8-4.5. And that to me was a bit of a disappointment, because if I want a longer lens, I'm looking at different cameras. And I think that one of the reasons the RX100 has been so popular is because of that fast little lens on there that makes it a fantastic standard lens and do everything camera for people. Now, Sony's kind of addressed that, because apparently the RX100 Mark VI is not necessarily the successor to the Mark V. They've now come out with the RX5 VA. They've basically given us that lens back, so we have a 24-70 equivalent, and that's a f1.8-2.8 lens. So we've still got our super fast lens, and we've also got some improvements. We've got a bigger buffer. We get 233 files versus 150. We got a proxy movie mode for 4K, so you can work with proxies easier because it'll do it in camera. We've got a zone AF area mode, so some improvements to the autofocus system, variable size spot metering, entire screen average and highlight spot metering. You've had the ability to put ratings on images and three auto white balance options. We got standard ambience or white. So some other tweaks beyond just getting that lens back. And none of them are stellar, but I guess for me, we've got the price back. So $998, whereas the Mark VI was $1,200. And I wouldn't have bought the Mark VI at more money with the lens I didn't want. So I guess what I'm wondering is how many of you out there are happy to see the VA, and that's the camera you would go with the faster, less range zoom. In other words, the 24-70 with the f1.8-2.8 versus the Mark VI that has that, what, 24-200, I think it is. Yeah, 24-200, 35 mil equivalent terms, obviously, but a 2.8-4.5, so a much slower lens. I'm just curious to see what you guys think here. Is the Mark VI with the longer, slower lens more to your liking? Or is the Mark V VA, or I don't know how you're supposed to say that, Mark V A or RX100 VA, is that more to your liking with the shorter lens, the 24-70, but the faster lens? I'm just curious. Let me know in the comments below. How do you feel about this? Was the Mark VI something you got excited about? Were you disappointed like me because it had a slower lens even though it was longer? Are you happy now that the VA is out and that that's the one you would go with? Again, I'm not sure how you say that. Is it a Mark V A? I guess that's probably what it is. Just when it says RX100 VA, you just kind of naturally default to saying it that way. In any case, let me know in the comments below. Let's discuss it. What's your thoughts on the RX100, the 6 versus the 5A? Let's talk about it. Which one appeals more to you? Is there something you would have liked to seen in the 5A that we have in the 6? Is there something missing from all of them? Is this not your type of camera? Let's discuss it. I got to say, you can do a lot with these cameras. If you haven't played with one, it's very tempting to have one of these in your pocket, and then it quickly becomes a replacement for your DSLR, because especially if you're not used to how good the 1-inch sensors are these days, I think it's going to blow you away, because the 1-inch sensors in these new cameras are performing at or above the levels of original, like earlier APS-C. Actually, I would say above, but let me know. Let me know what you guys think. Looking forward to seeing your comments below. Thanks for tuning in. Stay tuned. We'll be back soon here at ArtOfTheImage.com.